For all my beginning videographers and photographer, have you ever wondered why your photos or videos are too dark or too bright, or why some shots are crisp while others are blurry? Well, today we'll be breaking down the mystery behind your camera settings. To start off with this process, I want to introduce you guys to the exposure triangle as a foundation of photography and videography, and let's briefly get into some of the key elements that go into that exposure triangle. One is going to be your aperture, number two is going to be your shutter speed, and number three is going to be your ISO. And if you stick around to the end, what I'll be doing is I'll share a free cheat sheet to make all of this so much easier to remember, and so you can have it on set or while you're out filming. Now, let's get into the exposure triangle, right? So as you can see through this graphic right here, here's what your exposure triangle looks like. And it composes of the three things that we talked about earlier, which is your aperture, your shutter speed, and your ISO. And you'll see those at each corner of the triangle. Now, we're gonna compare the exposure triangle to a faucet. So your aperture is going to be like the faucet opening size or the amount of light that you can let in. Your shutter speed is going to be how long the faucet stays open or your duration. And your ISO is going to be like your water pressure. And we'll equate that to light sensitivity. Now, let's do a deep dive into your aperture settings, right? So the size of the lens opening is measured in f-stops. So if you have an f2.8, it's gonna be a wide opening. And if you have an f16, it's gonna be a super small opening, a super tight opening. So the more open your aperture, the more light you let in, and the more shut your aperture, the less light you let in. So for instance, if you're shooting a portrait with about a 2.8 f-stop, that's going to give you a nice blurred background, which is a shallow depth of field, and it's going to allow more light into your lens, giving you an overall brighter image. Now, if you're shooting something like a landscape and you want that sharp, crisp background or a deep depth of field, you're going to crank that aperture up to a 16 so that you can have that nice, sharp image all around. And also, remember, guys, depending on what you're shooting, whether it's portraits, landscapes, or micro photography, or videos, etc., you want to keep that aperture in mind, and you want to keep in mind what type of background and what type of image you're trying to compose. So with that being said, let's do a deep dive into your shutter speed. So your shutter speed essentially is measuring the duration that your camera sensor is going to be exposed to light, and it's going to measure that in fractions of a second, right? So like 1/1000th or 1/30th, just to show you some examples. Now let's show you some demonstrations of how that could actually look. So if you're looking for something that's a super crisp shot like this over here, something like a sports shot where you want to freeze that motion and really get the subject clean and crisp, you want to have maybe like a 1/1000 shutter speed. And if you want something that's maybe a little bit more natural to the human eye so you can get the movement and everything like that, you're going to have a 1/50 shutter speed, right? So just keep that into mind. And if you crank that shutter speed down a little bit lower, you can do cool stuff like light trails and stuff like that. You know, and this is important for the beginning videographer and photographer to know so that you can maximize your camera. So now let's explain your ISO, right? Which is the light sensitivity. And these values range in hundreds from 1, 400, 500, 800, etc. So essentially less ISO, a darker image, higher ISO, a brighter image. So this is the difference between a ISO 100, a nice clean image right here, and on the other end you'll see an ISO 3200, where you get more noise in your image. It's a brighter image that you can do in your camera, kind of adjust those settings, but again, you can get more noise when you're cranking that ISO up. So if you're in brighter conditions, you want to crank that ISO down. And if you're in darker conditions, you do want to crank that ISO up, but keep in mind that you don't want to get any grain or anything like that in your footage. So that being said, let's talk about balancing your exposure triangle so that you can get an overall well-composed image using your shutter, your aperture, and your ISO. So if you adjust one setting, like let's say your ISO, you'll see that the image gets brighter in one setting, right? But you might need an image like you're shooting a sports game where you need, a more clean, crisp image, but you still kind of maybe want that blurred background. So you crank that shutter speed up so you can capture less motion in your actual frame. You'd still maybe be shooting at an f2.8 so you can let more light in, because as you crank that shutter speed up, it is going to make your image darker. So in order to balance that, you're going to need to adjust your aperture and your ISO. So keep that in mind as you're going along, and vice versa. If you're adjusting your aperture to, like, let's say f16, f16 stop, then you're going to want to adjust your ISO and you're going to want to adjust your shutter speed to compose the right image overall, so that you're getting a clean, crisp, sharp, evenly lit image at all times, right? So always keep those three things in mind. Always keep the exposure triangle in mind as you're going through these steps. So let's do a quick recap. So your aperture is going to be light and depth. Your shutter speed is going to be motion. Your ISO is going to reinforce the brightness in your image so that you can get great videos and great photos, right? So I hope this is making you feel more confident about your camera settings. Now, this is what I talked about in the beginning of the video. If you go down to the description, there's a free cheat sheet there for you, right? There's a free cheat sheet there for you so that you can know about your aperture, your ISO, your shutter speed, excuse me. And it has some exposure triangles and different tools that you can be looking at while you're on set. You can have this in your pocket as a tool so that you can be taking your content and what you're doing to the next level, making sure that you're always getting a nice, crisp image. Now, for my beginning photographers and videographers, these three components right here, your aperture, your ISO, and your shutter speed are what's going to determine the quality of your work. And it makes the difference between having a high quality, crisp end product that you can present to your family if you're doing photos, kids, or if you're getting into some paid work. You want to make sure that you know these things so that you're delivering the highest quality, right? Because you can have a $500 camera and produce $6,000 images and get compensated accordingly. And you can have a $6,000 camera and not know anything about your settings, your aperture, your ISO, your shutter speed, the exposure triangle, composing a properly well-lit image. And you could get a $500 image, even a $5 image from a $6,000 camera, right? So often we think, oh, I need the best camera. Oh, I need this. Oh, I need that. And at a point, you do. But in the beginning, it's important to know these settings, guys. Give me a like, follow, subscribe, check me out. I got a ton of more content coming for you guys. And this is for all my beginners who are looking to take it to the next level in 2025. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.